Video and photos circulating on social media reveal an anti-racism protest to air grievances about a teacher at Indian Springs High School in San Bernardino, California, turned violent on Tuesday. One scene documented showed security officers tackling students and even kneeling on the neck of one black student, which you can see pictured here. Now, there's another video which shows an unidentified school official grappling with a student outside of a classroom. Leading up to the tussle, the pair were arguing before the teen appears to swat the older man's phone away, prompting the adult to throw up his hands. Another angle shows the moment a security officer deployed pepper spray into a crowd of over 100 students during this protest. Now, according to a Facebook post made by one of the student organizers, Gianna Woods, myself and a friend of mine held a peaceful walkout at Indian Springs High School in an attempt to remove racist staff and educators from our campus after being reported multiple times. These reports range from sexual harassment, verbal assault, discrimination based on sexual orientation, race, and religion. The protest turned violent after one of our staff assaulted a student. From there, four other innocent arrests were made, as well as an entire group of children being pepper sprayed with no medical attention. Even after the various altercations, we kept a large majority of students on the right track, and ultimately change was made. We got to speak with someone who is finally on our side and is willing to listen. Now, Woods named the teacher in question further in her post. Because we can't independently verify the claims, we've redacted the teacher's name. Now, this teacher, she says, is the name you need. He was our last straw. My personal encounters with him have included verbal assault, sexual harassment, discrimination based on race and religion, bullying, as well as the push of political beliefs and consequences if not complied with. School should be a safe space, not a battlefield. And she is exactly right. Now, she also included in her post numerous photos and videos from Tuesday's walkout, saying they serve as proof of the peaceful nature of the protest before things became violent. Now, the school district has issued their side of the story. According to KCAL News, according to the San Bernardino Unified School District, students began their protest at about 11 a.m. They were trying to air their grievances about the specific teacher when the demonstration grew into a large, unruly crowd after a group tried to enter a classroom to disrupt lessons. School officials said that staff intervened and tried to disperse the crowd when the campus security started using pepper spray on students. No injuries were reported, but two students were examined by the nurse. Some students were detained and will face discipline. However, it is unsure if they are facing criminal charges. District said they are investigating claims made against a specific teacher that was the cause of the protest. First, I want to say those students absolutely should not be facing charges. These are children, these are minors. And the last thing on earth that we need is more kids locked up in our prison system. Or even with a criminal record, that's going to impair their ability, you know, to be successful moving forward. We'll also say that these students were demonstrating their free speech rights. They had the right to gather, they had the right to protest. And, you know, if things did become rowdy, the school could have handled it much better than dispersing pepper spray into a group in an enclosed area of 100 students, even though they only say there was no injuries reported. I mean, you know, the trauma of being attacked by police officers in their own school where they're meant to feel safe is going to stick with them. Jackson.
Well, you know, look at how alive and well all the isms are in this country. Meanwhile, you know, we're trying to ban books that talk a little bit about diversity or talk about our history whatsoever while we're trying to, you know, ban critical race theory all over the place. But it's just really crazy to think about how these really are just human traits that we have to deal with that we haven't dealt with properly. Racism, classism is still alive and well in this country. And it doesn't matter if it's adults protesting or a bunch of kids protesting. I mean, we were talking about before this show started about how the 2024 primary Republican elections pretty much already handed to Donald Trump, while liberal pundits and conservative pundits act like the Republican Party is ready to move away from these kinds of things. Where? What are you talking about? Since when? You know, but this is the country that we live in, and these issues are still very real, and we have to deal with them properly. So. It's just unfortunate to see.
Absolutely. I'm glad that the students claim that they've met with someone who's going to hear them out. But you know, especially the type of police response to protesting is so systemic that we're even seeing it in protests within these schools. So you're right, it really is, you know, a massive issue that needs to be addressed at a national level.